Do your court's briefing requirements include a strict word count limitation? Microsoft Word's word count feature has a few quirks you'll want to be aware of before you turn in your next brief. Hi, I'm Deborah Saavedra with LegalOfficeGuru.com, the resource for legal professionals using Microsoft Office, and in this series, I'm talking about how to meet specific brief formatting requirements. Earlier in this series, I gave an example of a state whose brief length requirements specified that certain briefs must be limited to X number of pages. But some state appellate and federal courts' brief length requirements are expressed in number of words rather than number of pages. While Word does have an easy-to-access word count feature, there are some quirks you'll want to be aware of. Counting words in a Microsoft Word document is a pretty straightforward exercise. If you have your status bar tricked out so that you're actually showing the number of words in the status bar, and to do that, if you right-click on the status bar, just make sure that the check mark is showing next to word count. You can either turn it on or off. Then you can see the number of words here. But here's the trick. Does that word count include this footnote? Maybe, maybe not. The only way to really check, because it's not showing here, is to either click on this or go to the Review tab and click on Word Count to bring up the actual dialog box. There's an option here on this checkbox to show the word count for things like text boxes, footnotes, and endnotes. And whether or not this checkbox is checked will actually affect what's shown in the status bar. But keep in mind, this word count is actually showing you the word count for the entire document. And if you're submitting a brief or other pleading to a court that requires that you show the word count, you may not want to include any introductory material, such as a table of authorities or a table of contents, or the signature block, the certificate of service, etc. So, what I recommend you do is just select the section of the document that you want to count, and then bring up the word count dialog. Now, you notice that down here it says 491 of 575 words. So, it's showing you the subset of this document. This has 491 words. But you can bring up the word count dialog box to double check and make sure that that is including that text, that footnote. Now, some of you may be thinking, aha, I know of a field that you can actually embed in your document that will give you the word count automatically. Well, here's a little wrinkle. Go down here to word count. Go to the Insert tab, go to Quick Parts, and choose Field. Yes, you can choose a field called NumWords. You can tell it how to format, etc. What you can't do in the options for that field is tell it whether or not to include footnotes, endnotes, or text boxes. And in matter of fact, it does not. So you notice that this is not counting the words in the footnote, and that differs from what's shown down here and also what's shown in the word count. So be aware that there are some limitations to that NumWords field. And in fact, honestly, I'd like to challenge Microsoft, if this is not already on your development priority list, this would be a great thing to do for lawyers, is to modify this field so that it actually has some field-specific switches, very much like, some of these other fields, where there are settings that are specific to that particular field. And the switches that I'd like to see is, number one, to include the footnotes, endnotes, and text boxes in the word count, And number two, to be able to limit the word count to a particular section of the document, because that would be just tailor-made for people who are trying to count the number of words in their brief proper, so to speak, without including anything in the introductory material or in the certificate of service or anything like that. So that would be something I would love to see coming up in Microsoft Word 2019. I hope that's on the development list for Microsoft, but if it's not, I suggest it.
You can use this count words in a selection trick while you're writing your brief to ensure you're staying within your limit, but you'll obviously want to wait until your brief is ready to publish before making a final count and inserting that word count wherever it's required. Speaking of things in your brief you want to ensure are 100% compliant, chances are your brief requires a table of authorities. Make sure yours is error-free with my free Table of Authorities pre-publish checklist. My checklist will show you the 10 most common problems you'll run into with TOA, with links to helpful articles and videos on how to fix them. To make sure your TOA is up to standards before you print or PDF your next brief, click on the link above or in the description below and download your checklist today.